Hello and good afternoon, everyone. Konstantin, aka Mr. B, back on another weekend with another video and the question whether the ETA 2824 really is a better movement like the Sellita SW200. Let's find it out after the intro. Let's go. Guys, let's change the perspective to check out each movement on its own and afterwards compare them both against each other to find out which one is the best. Let's start with the ETA 2824 movement. We do have here a diameter of 25.6 millimeters, a height of 4.6 millimeters. You do have an hour and minute hand as well as a central seconds. It's an automatic movement with a datum complication. You do have 28,800 beats per hour, which is 4 hertz, 25 stones, and a power reserve of 42 hours. From the ETA movement to the Sellita as well, you have here the minute, hour, and second hand. It's as well an automatic movement with a datum complication. The watch beats as well with 28,800 beats per hour. Four hertz does have 26 stones and a power reserve of 38 hours. The diameter is 25.6 millimeters, the height 4.6 millimeters. So in this matter, it's similar or the same in terms of the dimension like the ETA. I myself have the Marcello C. Tridente in my collection, which sports actually the 2824 movement. I as well did have the Oris Aquis with a Sellita movement. Both of them do perform very well. The Marcello C. is in my collection since 11 years, I think now. The Oris was as well in my collection for quite a long time and both did perform very well. The Oris was regulated very good as well was the Marcello or is the Marcello C. I did as well ask my friends in my WhatsApp group what is their opinion about both of the movements and I actually didn't get a pro or a con for both of them. Both movements did perform in their collections very well. They haven't got problems with the one or the other. If the ETA was sometimes a little bit slower than the Sellita, on the other hand, another guy had a Sellita which performed better than his ETA movement. So it's very balanced and an overall very equal result if you compare them with each other. Let's compare the Sellita with the ETA side by side. The ETA movement is on the left side, the Sellita on the right side. I think you can tell directly that the Sellita movement is a one-to-one clone of the ETA movement. Of course, you can get different grades of decorations for both of them. In terms of diameter and height, both are the same either. Just the Sellita has one stone more, where the ETA has 42 hours of power reserve. The Sellita does have 38 hours. On the other hand, both are more or less the same. And I think without the marks, you couldn't tell a difference on the first glance.
So let's summarize and get the conclusion. From my point of view, it makes no sense to say the ETA movement is better than the Sellita movement. Of course, if you would like to split hairs, you can actually argue that the ETA movement has a longer history, it's the original one, it's got a power reserve of 42 hours. But in the reality, in the test, in everyday carry, both movements do perform the same. It has a big impact of how a brand does regulate the movement. So you can have very good results with an ETA movement as well. You can have very good results with the Sellita movement. So both of them do perform great and I don't care, I don't mind whether I have a Sellita or an ETA movement in one of my watches. Alright guys, this concludes the battle ETA versus Sellita. I hope you did like this content and I do plan actually to battle the ETA 2824 versus the ETA Powermatic 80. So if you do like this topic, please leave a note in the comment section below. As well, what is your opinion? Do you prefer the Sellita over the ETA or vice versa? Share this with me in the community. I look forward to write with you there. Wish all of you now a very happy afternoon, a good weekend, a good start into the new week. Look forward to see you in the next one. Say goodbye and auf Wiedersehen. Euer Konstantin. Ciao, guys.
And just for the case that I heard complaints about my beautiful haircut before in the video, I just went out to the barber to get a good trim for my beautiful hair. So, yeah.
fresh shaven for the weekend. Have a good one. Ciao, guys.